I wish to thank the organizers, Klaas Farnbaum, for his arrangements. He's been very kind and helpful. It's nice to be here, and you are a good host. And Jerome Bovee, who started Presbymania a number of years ago. It's always an honor and a pleasure to be here. I want to report on the initial experience with the Presby Max LASIK. Now, we know that presbyopia can be treated in different ways, and we are going to discuss Presby Max. I'm not going to elaborate on that anymore. It was developed by Schwind in cooperation with Prof. Alio and the Ocubus group from the University of Alicante. We say that we do not have financial interest in this treatment. It's of course not true. Patients pay me, so I have a lot of financial interest in this treatment. And here we have the laser, the Schwind MRS, the Sirius wavefront aberrometer, and the keratome is not on the picture, but you all know it. The ablation profile is applied to the stroma with a normal LASIK procedure. It's a bi-aspheric multifocal ablation profiles, very similar to the previous profiles we saw. Central cornea for near vision, mid-peripheral cornea for far vision. And here we see the ablation pattern. That's for near vision, then that's for intermediate, and that's for distant vision. It distributes light in different percentages. As we see here, 35-40% for near, 15 intermediate, and 45 for far. Patient selection, we all know the patient selection criteria, and it's no different for laser treatment than for multifocal IOLs. If you look at the ocular factors for these patients, they must be over 40, which of course is a debatable point. It can be 38 or 43 or whatever, but he must be presbyopic. No ocular pathology, best corrected vision 0.8, near vision with a 150 at 0.63. In their brochure, they say it's J4, I think it's J3. The refraction variation is visible for you to see, the astigmatism to -3. And we use cytoplegic refraction, sorry, wrong button. And for myopia, we use the manifest refraction. We do corneal wavefront. The patient must not have keratoconus or irregular astigmatism. The KD range must be between 40 and 48, perimetry more than 500. And then we measure the photopic, mesopic, and scutopic pupils. The pupil must have normal motility. Photopic pupil 2.5 to 3, and scutopic pupil minimum 4.5. And then what happens after the operation? Your pupils still obviously have an effect. I like to memorize 3, 4, and 5 millimeters. 3 millimeters covers near vision. 4 millimeters covers new term that I have devised 3 days ago, social vision, 2 meters. It's nice for me to remember, 4 millimeters social vision. 5 millimeters distant vision. Post-op pupil effect, in good light, you will read better. And sunglasses improve distant vision. And these two recommendations from the company emphasize the fact that Presby Max treatment has very specific limitations and limited usefulness. I'm not saying it's not good, I'm saying it's limited and you must know when to use it, and that's not so easy always. Expected satisfaction from high to low. Hyperopes, the high astigmatism, high myopes, they will most likely be satisfied. Reason being, you take them out of their glasses. They were forced to use glasses always before the operation. Afterwards, they never have to use glasses. Emmetropes, they have excellent distant vision before the time. And if you do anything to them that changes their excellent distant vision, they're not happy. Same goes for low myopes, just for near vision. Key factors then, the 3 refractive errors, as I said, and then you should do a contact lens trial, which makes it a lot safer, because It's very easy to determine the patient's reaction to a contact lens strike. If it doesn't work, don't place it. Or fog, the refraction from far and near, that also works to a certain extent. Treatment plan, we always do both eyes. Micro monovision is always an option, because monovision in principle is a good treatment. And then presbyopia maximum at 0.5 to 2.8 diopter pseudo accommodation. You get what the laser is pre-programmed to give you. The moment you put in the age of the patient, the laser gives you an addition of pseudo accommodation. And the results are enhanced by depth of focus. Treatment plans, I always put in treatment of optical zone of 7 mm. The company will recommend other zones. I don't think it's worth even looking at it, but that's what they say. Technique, we do a LASIK. It's aberration-free treatment. It's on the corneal vertex. Now, I don't agree with the company. They say it must be on the corneal vertex. I just don't agree with it. Because if you have a very large angle kappa, and you put this treatment on the corneal vertex, the patient will not look through the central, most prolate part of the cornea for distant, for near vision. And now you will say to me, yes, but the algorithm was calculated for the apex of the cornea. I accept that. Therefore, if you put it on the non-apical part of the cornea a little bit more nasally, you probably won't get the result you want. But I still don't agree with the principle of putting it on the apex always. Then we use offset and we use SCC, which is slight cyclotorsion control in cases of large astigmatism. Now, we didn't do many cases. You will remember the title of my talk is Initial Results. I'm very gingerly when it comes to corneal treatment for refractive, for presbyopia. I don't really think it's fantastic treatment. Now, our results, 1 or 2 lines, less than 6 or 6 for distant uncorrected vision. These patients lose a little bit of distant vision. Even if they are, if I say lose 2 lines, I mean they don't get 6-6. They get 0.8 vision, which is 7.5 or 20-25. Some of them even get a little bit less. They get good. These patients, we got 6 eyes only in the series, they are happy with their near vision, and they are happy with their intermediate vision. With best corrected vision, they lost a bit of clarity. Micromonovision, of course, can improve the results. Contrast sensitivity, they did not complain about it, was moderately reduced, but it didn't bother them. Halos and starbursts, not very problematic. All three patients are very happy. That's very interesting for me, because from where I stand, the results are not good. But they complain a bit about distant vision. Only 1 out of 6 eyes had a good refraction post-op. No eyes lost more than 1 line of best corrected vision, but they did lose 1 line. And if you look then at refractions of the 6 eyes, look at post-op refractions, -150, 150, 150, 125, 1, 1. These people are all myopic. So that's why they can read. Of course they have the central, very controlled eyelid, but it's still a central eyelid. The cylinders, there's one of the large cylinder, and the uncorrected vision 0.63, 1.0 with a good, with a high cylinder, look at that. And then this patient is a very happy lady. She started out with a +2 both eyes, she's -150, she's ecstatic. She sings my praises every time she sees me. This guy is a bit more exacting, and he wants to see a little bit better for distance. And this patient is somewhere in the Congo. We couldn't do all his follow-ups, and he says it's wonderful, because for the first time in years he can read. So there is a place for this treatment, but you must do the right patient. Complications then, myopia reducing vision, astigmatism only 1 eye, And then the optical complications, halo stars, ghost images, everybody notices it, but nobody really has a problem with it. And then there we have our graph, basically says the same what I said just now. And the intermediate vision, 100%, near vision, quite good. And then the discussion of this treatment, it's a compromise. Like all these multifocal treatments of the cornea and the lens, it's a compromise. You gain something, you lose something. You lose quality, and you gain quantity. You gain spectacle independence for all distances. You lose some contrast, you lose some night vision, and for the right patient it works. For the wrong patient, exactly the same result will be inadequate. Sorry, one too quick. Subjective facts then, 3 out of 3 patients in our small series are happy. It's about making the patient better. I remember I gave a talk in South African Congress about 10 years ago and I said surgery is done to make the patient better. And they laughed at me, crazy. We have a list of 100 surgical indications. How can you just run up here and say it is done to make the patient better? But it is done to make the patient better. If you